Good day everyone, my name is Kevin. I'm the head of trading in OSL Digital Securities. Today we are going to talk about DeFi, or decentralized finance. In the next 5 minutes, we are going to talk about the 3 reasons why we think DeFi is not really decentralized. First of all, what exactly does the word decentralized mean in DeFi? What is the centralized equivalent of DeFi? In the narrowest terms, DeFi allows you to make use of financial instruments like borrowing and lending without the needs of a banking intermediary on the other side of the trade, so practically you are trading P2P. In this sense, indeed, DeFi does not require you to open an account in a bank to borrow or lend cryptocurrency, which is ironic because most banks don't steal crypto yet. In a slightly broader term, it also means that you don't have to open an account in a centralized crypto exchange. But beyond the narrowest definitions, DeFi is not really decentralized, and here are the reasons. Reason 1. Counterparty risk is not decentralized. In traditional finance, the risk of the opposite end of the trade not being fulfilled as contract most often lies with the intermediaries. That's what we call the counterparty risk. In DeFi, however, your counterparty risk does not really lie with the pool of users just because it is a P2P service. The highest probability of failure of delivering the opposite end of the trade is often the DeFi platform itself, so your risk has not been decentralized. On the contrary, in a lot of cases, the counterparty risk of DeFi is much higher than dealing with the banks, as DeFi platforms and projects lack appropriate risk profile assessment by either third-party credit rating agency or by the regulators. Reason 2, there are components in DeFi platforms that are still on Web 2.0 and not really decentralized. Most notable examples are the project's website or social media accounts like Twitter and Facebook, as well as communication channels like Telegram and Discord. While the DeFi smart contracts may be decentralized, project teams can easily change or even remove project's website and social media, which can easily jeopardize the project. It may sound unreal to you, but as we have seen in the most recent case of Andre Cogna retiring and shutting down dozens of DeFi projects' websites, it may be more realistic and probable than you think. Reason 3, and this may be more a philosophical debate. The interest of DeFi platform and the interest of the users and community can never be 100% fully aligned all the time. And when there are conflicts of interest, there is no easy solution to universally tackle all situations. Simply put, this is just a reflection of the shortfall of democracy in modern society. Imagine if the platform's interest took precedence, then it can be criticized for not being truly decentralized, or some would say truly community governed. If the community's interest took precedence, then it can also be criticized for tyranny of the majority. The prime example we see recently is Juno Network. They announced an airdrop where holders of Atom can receive a maximum of 50,000 coins per wallet addressed. A whale used multiple wallets to bypass this upper cap, and eventually received more than 3 million tokens. Later, the community proposed and passed a governance vote to take back those coins from the whale. The controversy here is the whale has not done anything illegal, not hacking, not stealing. It may be socially or morally unacceptable, but by a simple majority of voting among the community, they can now take the coins back from someone who contractually owns them on the blockchain. Obviously, the whole event reports into a much bigger debate in the crypto community, with the most basic and fundamental principles of cryptocurrency and blockchains being questioned and challenged. Long story short, such conflicts can ultimately be resolved by having a hard fork between the two groups of people disagreeing with each other. Most notably, the Ethereum hard fork in 2016 that spun out Ethereum Classic. However, DeFi projects are extremely unlikely to survive a hard fork due to the potential issues with the split of reserves, development, and community. So these are the 3 reasons why I believe that DeFi is not really decentralized, or not decentralized in the sense people may expect. Now obviously, this is not a video trying to undermine the importance of DeFi. On the contrary, I believe that DeFi will have an integral role in the cryptocurrency ecosystem going forward. Decentralized finance and centralized finance will hopefully form a healthy equilibrium based on different use cases. Now, if you think DeFi should be positioned or defined differently in the market, feel free to comment below. And as always, remember to subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos going forward. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.